Welcome to Moorea.
These are my adventures in biology on the island of the yellow lizard. Among my first stops on the island was the Intercontinental Resort and Spa, home to a sea turtle clinic for injured and rescued turtles. Dr. Cecile Gaspar is founder of the Turtle Clinic and associated nonprofit society Te Moana o Te Moana. As both a marine ecologist and a veterinarian, Dr. Gaspar has been rehabilitating sea turtles for over a decade.
So clearly we started with this turtle clinic because basically it was a need. We were called by some local fishermen, some local residents, telling us, I found a turtle, could you take care of it? Because, you know, I'm a vet, so... And I was, I'd like to, but we need to have a good place for that.
Cecile presented her case to the owner of the Intercontinental, knowing full well that in order to be effective in helping turtles, she needed a lot of support.
This is the list of what we need. You know, we need a lagoon, we need some nursery, we need a clinic to take care of them, and maybe down the road we need an office, and then we need an education room, like a classroom, because we do a lot of education.
The hotel owner obliged, and the nonprofit society was created. Injured turtles from all over French Polynesia come to Te Moana o Te Moana. They have agreements with many local transportation companies and airlines to make sure the turtles reach them safely.
The main cause of injuries is the poaching.
It's poaching,
yeah,
okay.
We have a lot of injuries by spear gun in the neck, in the head. Very, very strong injuries, very difficult to take care of.
We meet Tortilla, a hawksbill turtle that arrived at the center with extremely deep gashes in her right pectoral fin.
Tell us what happened here. She got caught in some fishing line.
Yeah, and so this was entangled around the flipper. And as you can see, there was a very deep cut. This is in a very good state of recovering, but there's still some dead skin we want to clean up. So you can see it was very, very deep. That's why some nerves have been damaged, and that's why she's not moving it at... You know, she was before. Yes, so you know, everything that is like this.
This is just scar tissue?
Yeah. And what we don't want is behind this to have another infection going on.
A quick application of antibiotic ointment and Tortilla is good to head back to the lagoon.
Okay.
But we quickly notice that she's still not really using her injured fin.
She needs more time.
Another long-term resident is Matapo, a large hawksbill rendered permanently blind from a spear gun wound to her head.
Yeah, you got it. Don't take the stick. Oh,
she doesn't want to give it up.
Oh, right in the mouth. That's awesome. Okay, now.
Next, it's feeding time for some rescued juveniles and some brand new hatchlings that were just brought in from one of the nearby motus. The hatchlings were stranded in a deep hole. They were dehydrated and would certainly not have made it without the center's intervention.
We are at these two-day-old turtles. We are going to feed them. If you look, Matthew has got food on his finger, this mulched-up baby food. This is the first time that they will have eaten. So it's important to make sure that each turtle is actually eating, because if it's not eating, that could signify some kind of a problem. How's it looking? Did one of them have a little bit of chow?
Oh, look, they hit.
That one, yeah. He got it!
After lunch, we head out to some nearby reefs because Te Moana o Te Moana isn't just a rescue center. They're actively monitoring hawksbill and green turtle populations around the islands. It's the coolest research protocol that I have experienced. Being towed behind the boat while looking for turtles. Once a turtle's been spotted, Matthew free dives down to catch it with his bare hands.
Okay.
Once caught, the turtles are brought on board where they're weighed, measured, and tagged. A tissue sample is also taken for DNA analysis. And then it's back into the drink they go.
All right, here we go. Woo! All in a day's work.
I have to say, I was so impressed by the turtle work going on at Te Moana o Te Moana. I had some skepticism going into it about the legitimacy of a rescue center attached to a major tourist hotel. But Te Moana o Te Moana is making a massive difference for sea turtles in French Polynesia. What a fantastic place to visit. And what a responsible choice by the owners of the Intercontinental.
Okay, so that's it for today.
Thank you. Welcome to Moorea.
In the next episode, I get up close and personal with some sharks and stingrays. Come on back or subscribe to my channel for more excellent adventures in biology.